So here we have the Hyundai Tucson on a 17 plate. I'm going to start off by showing you inside the boot, and then we'll hop in and run through some controls on the inside of the car from there. As you can see, the tailgate on this car opens electronically. We have reversing sensors, a reversing camera, and plenty of boot space, as well as that 60-40 split folding rear seat should you wish to increase the space even further. And then underneath this tray section, a full-size alloy spare wheel. Okay, now that we're inside the car, we're going to start with the dials. On the left-hand side, we have the rev counter. On the right-hand side, the speedometer and fuel gauge. In the middle, you can see the total miles of the car. They are 27,023. Above that, we have the main trip computer section for the car. So you can change the information displayed there. For example, you can have a digital readout for the speedometer. There are other menus available as well. So that's the driving data menu. But we have satellite navigation, vehicle systems. We have your audio menu, vehicle settings, and user settings. Then we're back around to the beginning again. And the buttons I was using to do that are just here. We've also got cruise control and speed limiter over there. On the left-hand side, we have stereo and phone controls. And you can mute the stereo from up here as well. In the center, you'll find the stereo itself. And of course, as you can see, satellite navigation. There's a full video showing how the sat-nav works, which you can find on our website and also on our YouTube channel as well. We have access to the radio, of course. And as you can see at the top, we have DAB radio. This car will also have AM and FM. If you want to send your own music, press the media button. Nothing is connected at the moment, which is what it's going to say there. We can connect up an auxiliary device, a USB device. We can stream our music wirelessly via Bluetooth audio as well. And we have Apple CarPlay and Android Auto available. So plenty of ways to listen to music in this car. If I pop the vehicle into reverse, you'll see the reversing camera that I mentioned that goes along with the parking sensors, which you can hear there as well. Working our way down, we have dual zone climate control. So you can adjust the passenger temperature, the driver temperature. You can increase and decrease the fan speed, determine what direction you'd like the air to be distributed in once it enters the car. This button then turns your air conditioning off in this case, back on again. You can see it's on here and with the light there. Or hit auto, the car will now maintain these temperatures by taking control of the fan speed and the direction of the air for you. You can override that whenever you wish to. Below that, we have heated driver seat with three different heat settings, heated passenger seat, again with three different heat settings, a heated steering wheel, and it goes a few steps beyond that in that you've also got air conditioned driver seat with three different settings, and air conditioned passenger seat, again, three different settings. If you've never had this before, it's a fantastic extra, especially obviously on those very hot days. We have two 12 volt charging sockets, auxiliary and USB inputs, the gear lever for the fully automatic gearbox, and then these buttons just here. So we have an electronic handbrake. We can turn the parking sensors on and off. We have auto hold for the handbrake. Driving mode, I'll come back to in just a moment. We can press this button. This turns on the downhill brake control. This turns off the stop and start. This car's designed to cut out when it's stationary in traffic to save you fuel. That system is off when that light shows. This turns on the autonomous parking. So up here, the car will tell you what to do, what gear to shift into. It will look for a space for you, and you can turn that off as I just have. And the last one is that driving mode, and that puts the vehicle into sport or normal. The last thing I wanted to mention is the panoramic glass roofs. There's a button up here that will open up the sunblind section. You can just leave it with the sunblind open if you wish to, or you can open the front section as a full sunroof as well. All that leaves me to say is thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If you'd like to come and see the car in person and have a test drive, please feel free to call any of our MJA sites. We'd love to hear from you soon.